If you use Talkback, which is Android's screen reader, here's one way you can either learn or customize your experience. Welcome to Quick Accessibility Tips, Episode 4. Here is my Pixel, and I currently have Talkback on.
Settings, sheets.
You can do a three-finger tap or a swipe up and right L gesture to open the Talkback menu.
Talkback menu. Actions, enlist.
Then go down to Talkback settings.
Talkback settings.
And double tap on that. You can also go to settings, accessibility, then Talkback settings. Now we can swipe right until we find customized gestures.
Text, verbosity, sound and controls, customized focus indicator, customized gestures, 8 of 18.
And then we want to double tap on that one.
Practice gestures, 1 of 51.
You can practice gestures or reset gestures.
Reset gesture set.
That will return all the gestures to default. So now you can navigate by headings or just keep swiping right.
Swipe up, move navigation focus backward or adjust reading control up. Four. Swipe down, move navigation focus forward or adjust reading control down. 5 of 51.
So I can go to headings.
Lines, paragraphs, headings.
If I swipe down, I can go to another heading.
One finger back and forth, 8 of 50. One finger angle, 2 fingers, 22 of 51.
So now we have 2 finger gestures and we can swipe to the right.
Tap with 2 fingers, pause or resume speech, 23 of 51. Double tap with 2 fingers, play or pause media, 24 of 51.
Talkback will tell us the gesture and the action assigned to that gesture. If we wanted to change that gesture, we can double tap on one of these.
Double tap with 2 fingers, show custom actions. Checked. Player pause media. Start voice command.
Just as an example, I will double tap on this.
Talkback settings.
Now, if I double tap with 2 fingers, I can use the Talkback voice commands. Find Gmail.
Gmail.
Double there tap you go. Activate. I find that this is a really great way to learn different Talkback gestures and to customize your experience. Maybe there's some actions that you don't use so much, or maybe you want to copy over some of the gestures from iOS that maybe you're more familiar with. This allows you to completely customize your gestures and your experience. However, there are a few gestures which you are not able to change, and it will let you know which those are. Well, I hope this has been helpful for those of you who are maybe new to Talkback and Android. If you decide to try this or you've done this in the past, what are some of the modifications that you've done to Talkback gestures? I'd love to hear about it in the comments. And if you have a quick accessibility tip, you can share it down in the comments or send an email. My email is email@carryonaccessibility.com. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.